Hello, everyone, and welcome. We are so happy to have you with us today. And happy Memorial Day weekend to you. We hope it's been great thus far, but I believe it's going to get better from here. We're getting ready for a powerful service. I believe this 1 hour can change your life. And I also want to let you know that we're a prayer ministry, a ministry of prayer, and that we would love to get your prayer request. I'd love to be able to get them in my hand in real time and pray and call out the need. It's so easy to do. You just go to Faith City Family Church Facebook and you go to the send message section, or you go to YouTube in the chat section. Our ministry team is right over here, about 30 feet away, looking at the screens, ready to get your prayer request. Give me the name of a loved one, somebody who needs prayer. Maybe you're in the need of a mountain being moved. Whatever it is, when you do it, you're stretching your faith. And by the way, for Memorial Day weekend, we would like to do something very special for all of our veterans, those who have served, that are serving. We would love to give you a beautiful cross necklace. The reason we're doing this today is because I got to thinking about a program that I saw on television about our veterans, and they were recording the program at Arlington Cemetery. And when they did the shots of all of the grave sites, all of the crosses, thousands of crosses at Arlington Cemetery, it touched my heart. Friend, if you're a veteran or you did serve, or maybe you've got somebody, a relative, an aunt, an uncle, a niece, a nephew, and you would like us to send you or them across, just email us at faithcityoffice@gmail.com. That's faithcityoffice@gmail.com. It's so easy to do. I just need your address, and we would be honored to send you that cross. The cross says many, many things. But I want to remind you, in the next few minutes while we're worshiping and having a great time of praise and worship, to get those requests in. I want us to pray with the many who are watching. And by the way, we want to welcome all of our new viewers from all over the country, many different states being represented, and a couple of places even around the world. Welcome. And to all the Faith City Family Church family, can I give you a virtual hug right now? You don't know how bad I've been missing you. Oh, I can't wait till we get together again, and it's going to be very, very soon. Father, in Jesus' name, thank you for the opportunity to come together. And Lord, you told us in the Bible that God inhabits the praises of his people. Lord, I pray that everyone watching will, maybe even if they don't know the words to the song, they could clap their hands, they can make a joyful noise unto the Lord, and knowing that when the praises go up, the blessings, it will come down. Lord, I pray that people will feel free to give us their prayer requests and needs, knowing that we're going to call them out during this service. We're going to lift them up to God, believing for miracles. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Are you ready to make a joyful noise unto the Lord? Let's have a great time together. Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. If you believe that God is going to do something awesome in your life, there is nothing that anybody or anyone can do to take that away. God's promise is a yea and amen. And when he says yes, nobody says no. Hallelujah. Nobody can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
I'm not worried. Where he leads me, Lord, I will. can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
Hey, I'm not worried about a thing, 'cause I know you are guiding me. Where he leads me, Lord, I will go. I have no fear, 'cause I know. It all belongs to you. You're almighty and all powerful, and it all belongs to you. Yes, it all belongs to you. When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no. It all belongs to you. There's no limit to what you can do. 'Cause it all, yes, it all. You're almighty, powerful. All belongs to you. When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
Sound of the symphony,
like holy
water.
beautiful voice.
I don't wanna use your grace. God, I need it every day. It's the only thing that ever really makes me want to change it.
Oh,
I don't wanna use your grace. God, I need it every day. It's the only thing that ever really makes me want to change.
Sing it again.
I don't wanna use your grace.
Absolutely love that song, Crystal. That song is so awesome. God, I don't want to abuse your grace, because Lord, I need you every day. It's the only thing that helps me want to change. You know what? I got some great news for you today. Whatever you want to change in your life, you can do it. A habit that you want to break, something that you want to change that's been bothering you for years, there's power in the name of Jesus. And I'm going to get ready in a moment to make my way over to the cross. Because you see, when Jesus died on that cross, he took care of every bad habit, every trait that maybe you don't like about yourself. Maybe there's things just like you've said it a million times. Why do I keep doing this? Why can't I change? Why can't this? Why can't that? I've got good news. When you get Jesus in the center of your life, he will give you the power to make those changes. Are you ready for that power to come into your life? I believe that there are many of you watching right now, and what you need to do, you need to invite Jesus to come and live in you. Help me, Brother Chris, if you would, to live in you, to have a relationship with you. And all it is a prayer away. Let me make my way over to the cross over here. Because when I look at the cross, it says a lot of things to me. It says that Jesus loved me enough to take nails in his hands, in his feet, a crown of thorns upon his head. And he did it all because he loves you and me. And I believe today, if you'd be willing to say that prayer, I believe that if you would be willing today to say, Lord, help me to make the changes that I need to make, I know that God is able to do it. Are you ready to pray that prayer? I believe many of you are. Come on, let's do it. Look at the cross with me. Would you do that right now? And why don't you just stretch your hands out to the cross right now? Because I know that when you call on the Lord, he's listening. And he's gonna touch you where you need it the most. I'm going to ask Sister Crystal to repeat this prayer after me to encourage all of us. Are you ready? Come on. Everybody say it with me. Say, Jesus, I want to say thank you for dying on the cross for all my sins. Dear Jesus, I confess those sins. I ask you to forgive me and to wash my sin away. Right now, Jesus, help me to make the changes in my life that I need to make. I need a power in my life that's greater than myself. So I receive you today as my Lord and my Savior, as my helper, as my friend, and as my King. Thank you, Jesus, for helping me now. Amen and amen. Friend, if you prayed that, we are so excited. Friend, I almost want to run around this platform right now to think that the Lord has touched your life. You are not the same in the name of Jesus. And everything I say in Jesus' name is going to work out for the good. Well, we're going to get ready to pray. And I believe some prayer requests have come in. Brother Harmon, our outreach director, is going to get our prayer ministry request box. And we're going to pray for the hundreds of requests, not only in that box, and not only the requests that have come in, the many, in the last service that we had, but the requests that are coming in at this time. Now remember, it is not too late to get in your request. And if for some reason we do not pray for them now, if they come in just a little bit later, we're going to be praying again at the close. Get them in now. Faith City Family Church Facebook, the send message section, or YouTube, the chat section. I want to get your requests in my hand. Valerie says, pray that God will help me make a decision and lead me in the way that I should go. Amen, Sister Valerie. We're going to lift that up to the Lord today. Jeanette says, please pray for healing for Sister Gwendolyn. She's having joint pains and causing difficulty holding her weight up. Amen, Sister Jeanette and Sister Gwendolyn. We shall pray. This says, thank God for the opportunity to send in prayer requests. Lord, I need your help. Amen, Sister Jeanette. This says, pray for my son, Randy, that God would deliver him from all strongholds and demonic spirits in his life. Amen. We're believing for that. Please pray. Harrison says, please pray for Sean to be delivered from drugs and alcohol. Pray for BJ and Mary to be delivered from drugs. Yes, we will. Andre says, pray for Sister Andre's aunt, Cindy, is continuing her healing process. Amen. A praise report. Minister Marie has no fever today, and her breathing therapist is working with her. She is making progress. Praise God for that, and amen. Listen, it pays to pray. A 24-hour prayer request for Vaughn to get off of drugs. There's a 24-hour miracle needed there. And then Jeanette says, I'm asking God to heal our land. 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. Get in your prayer request right now. You see it on the screen. Facebook, send message. YouTube, the chat section. Pray for Eugene, Paramore, and Shadina, and Sharon Quarles. Amen. Now, Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, I hold every one of these in my hand. And I'm asking every one of you that are watching right now to agree with me in prayer. And I'm praying for a healing and deliverance to come into your life right now. Gwendolyn, be healed from your pain. Valerie, get the direction that you need. Be delivered off of drugs and alcohol, those of you that have just gotten your prayer request in. We pray for 24-hour miracles in the name of Jesus. God, I feel your power as I'm holding these requests in my hand right now. Thank you, Jesus, for this miracle deliverance prayer right now. In the name of Jesus, we're going to anoint them with oil, but more are coming in right now. Yes, Brother Harmon, here's another one right now. God bless you. Pastor Hare, please pray for my family and myself, Sister Christine, in the name of Jesus. Everything is going to be all right. Hallelujah. Now we're going to get out the anointing oil. And I believe when we touch these many requests that have come in, the hundreds that we have placed in the prayer request box, that miracles are going to take place. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, Brother Harmon and I, anoint every one of these in the name of God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Comforter, the Holy Ghost. God, I pray that healings would happen right now. Sister Gwendolyn, I believe the Lord is coming into your house and healing you right now. Start working those joints in the name of Jesus. God is healing you. Jeanette, God is working it out. Hallelujah. God, I thank you for 24-hour miracles. Valerie, God is giving you the direction that you need. Harrison, Sean will not be on drugs and alcohol. BJ will not, and Mary will not be on drugs. In the name of Jesus, God, we pray for miracle deliverance right now. I feel the power of the Holy Ghost. Somebody watching me, raise up your hand and praise God. As a matter of fact, God is touching you. You're watching me right now. I stretch my hand out to you right now in the name of Jesus, and God is healing you. He's delivering you. Somebody suffering from depression and schizophrenia, God is healing you right now in the name of Jesus. Somebody right now with a tumor, God is healing you from the top of your head to the soles of your feet. Somebody with an eating disorder, God is healing that right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Can we give God a praise for the miracles that are happening right now in the mighty name of Jesus? Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Now, friend, it is not too late to get in your prayer request. And I sense right now that the waters are troubled. Listen to me. Many of you watching, you need a 24-hour miracle. That's what you need. I need you to get that into our prayer team over here. They're looking at the screens right now. And at the close of the service, we're going to have a whole nother prayer time again. It is not too late to get in your prayer request, because I believe the miracle power of Jesus Christ is working right now. The team is over here about 30 feet on this side watching the screens, Faith City Family Church Facebook, YouTube, the chat section. Oh, hallelujah. Somebody give the Lord a shout right now. Miracle deliverance power is happening during this service. I want to say thank God for our ministry team that are here, whether it's streaming, ushering, my sister that is leading worship, Dana and the band, everybody here, too many names to call out right now, but I say to God be the glory for the miracle ministry that is going on. Let's give the Lord another hand right now. Praise God. And Sister Crystal, I believe you drove all the way from Baltimore, didn't you, to be here. Let's give God a praise. I tell you, we got some faithful people here at the ministry. Well, we're coming to that point of the service right now where we get to have the opportunity to give to the Lord's work. And as we know, so many need salvation. Brother BK, I feel led to do this right now about that cross necklace. When I got on my knees in front of that old little rugged cross over there, something came over me. It was like just inside my chest, I could hear like the voice saying, many are getting saved. Many are praying the salvation prayer. Many are saying, Lord, I don't want to live this way anymore. And I know that God is telling me to tell you, if you prayed that prayer, you need to get one of these cross necklaces. Why, Pastor? Because it will remind you that on Memorial Day weekend, 2020, you gave your life to Jesus. You turned the situation over to the Lord. I'd love to send it to you. All you got to do is email us at faithcityoffice@gmail.com. I need your address so that I can send it to you in the mail. Pastor Hare, you don't even know who I am. I never even been to that church before. You mean you would send me across? Let me tell you, we're about people. We're trying to help people. And if you feel this cross could help you, I want to send it to you by mail. Email me, faithcityoffice@gmail.com. I feel the power of God on this. I'm going to leave it up there another second. I feel there are many right now prayed that prayer, and the Lord is saying, get that cross necklace. It'll be a reminder and a testimony of what God did in your life. As we're preparing to give, see, it's so important that we're all reminded that during this pandemic season that we've got to reach out more than we've ever reached. We've got to remember that more people are open to the gospel, the message of the cross, than they've ever been. One of the most powerful verses on giving is found in Malachi, the 3rd chapter and the 10th verse. And that powerful verse of promise to those who give their tithes and their offerings reads as follows. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat, that there could be meat, that there will be meat in my house. And prove me now herewith, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. You see, in that one Bible verse, there are 3 blessings that are promised to those who will tithe, give 10% of the money that God blessed them with. First of all, it says, I'll pour you out a blessing. God said, I'll bless you. Secondly, he said, there will not be room enough to receive it. That refers to, he said, I'll increase you because I can trust you when I bless you. And thirdly, he said, I will rebuke the devourer, the devil, for your sake. He said, I will protect you. You, not only you, but your family, your children, your children's children. What a promise from the Bible today. Friend, I'm reaching out to you right now. And I'm asking you, would you be generous? The opportunities to get people saved are greater than ever. But it takes resources to do that. As soon as things loosen up, and things, thank God, we see progress on many fronts. And soon we'll be gathering together again very soon. But as soon as things loosen up, we're going to be right back out in the community sharing the message of the cross on the streets. But my mind goes back to one corner that we were on. It was a rough neighborhood, and some little children in the project saw the cross up on the corner. This one little fellow wanted to get his bag of goodies from the cross. This next young man was a little older, and they were praying for him because he said that his father, he had just lost his dad. Very quiet fellow. The folks at the corner, I remember talking to some of them when that happened. They said, we prayed for him, Pastor. He was hurting. He had just lost his daddy. What was the chance of him looking out the window and seeing a cross on the corner? You see, we've got to reach the children. Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me, for such is the kingdom of heaven. Just before the service, Brother Harmon was showing me on his phone that yesterday he was out in Wilmington and with a team out there handing out these packages of love, and the power of God showed up on the street. I saw it, and this one man started crying and getting a blessing on the street. People aren't hard to reach. It's easy. You just got to be willing to go. Just got to be willing to invest. And so, When I was talking to Brother Harmon and I got to thinking about those two boys, little boys in that outreach video. Brother Harmon, you shared with me, there you are over there, buddy, that we could use some children's Bibles. You see, many times we're just giving Bibles to adults, but a lot of these children, they don't have a Bible, never had one. We like to put the Word of God, a children's Bible with illustrations in their hand. Why? Because the sooner we can get a Bible in the hand of a young one, the Bible says in Proverbs 22:6, train up a child in the way it should go, and when it is old, it will not depart from it. Today in your giving, would you remember that? Would you remember we need your generosity, your tithes, your outreach offerings? We've made it so easy to give and secure. It doesn't take long. I'd like to bring up on the screen these simple ways. You can choose the text to give option. It's all secure. Or you could choose the Cash App. Just make sure you do that certain sentence, the dollar sign, Faith City, and the FC2, lower or uppercase, doesn't matter, but you must have the dollar sign. Or you can go to faithcitynow.com. Any of those are fast, convenient, and secure. If you'd like to send your tithes and offerings to the church, it'll come right to the front door, to the street address, Faith City Family Church, 179 Stanton Christiana Road, Newark, Delaware, 19702. Again, Faith City Family Church, 179 Stanton Christiana Road, Newark, Delaware, 19702. But I'm going to ask Brother Dana Saray to provide a very brief selection. And we're going to scroll up on the screen the various ways you can give. I'm asking everyone under the sound of my voice, everyone watching, what could you do? There's 1,000 more little boys out there to reach and little girls. Many of them need a Bible, never had one. There's no money in the house to go buy them one. Nobody has a car to go drive to a store and get one. But you can be a part of making an eternal difference in the lives of others. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for the book of Proverbs that says, he that wins souls is wise. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray that everyone watching will say, Pastor, I have no problem in paying my tithes and sending my tithes to the church, sending outreach offerings, because I know this world is not my home. I'm not going to live forever. And what I do for God and what I do for others, that will last forever in eternity. So, Lord, I thank you. Give us a miracle, we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you. Once again, we thank each and every one of you for helping to spread the good news of the gospel of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Before our special message, and remember, it's Communion Sunday this Memorial Day weekend. And remember, you can go in the kitchen or wherever you might be and get that little piece of bread, that cracker, that juice. And we're going to have communion together because there's miracle power in communion. But I also want to remind you that it's not too late to get in your prayer requests. At the end of the service, I'm going to be praying as the requests will continue to come forth for the miracles that are needed. I sense today that there are many watching. You need a 24-hour miracle, and I've seen so many of those happen since we begin to have that level of faith for them. Just go to Faith City Family Church Facebook, the send message section, or the YouTube chat section. I want to get those requests in my hand. I want to remind you that if you got saved, we would love to send you that cross necklace. Or if you serve our country, or you know of a veteran, somebody who could use a cross necklace, as when I think of that great cemetery in Arlington with all of the crosses there, we'd be honored to send out these crosses to you. Just mail me the address at faithcityoffice@gmail.com, faithcityoffice@gmail.com. I would be honored to get that in the mail to you. We've got some exciting things that are coming up. I want to remember one of the biggest things I think that's going to happen in the next few weeks is our honoring all graduates. Oh my goodness, I'm going to give them a hand in advance right now. Amen. I know that things have radically changed for our graduates in the year 2020. Many events have been canceled, but we want to amp it up. We want you to get the props and the recognition you deserve. Just email a picture of yourself, your name, and the name of your school. Email it to faithcityoffice@gmail.com. Also, I'm going to give you a beautiful 2020 graduation gift. We're going to put your picture up, your name, the name of your school, and I'm going to take my time and announce each graduate. It's going to be an exciting time. And of course, we won't be forgetting Dad. Father's Day, June the 21st, 9 a.m., 11 a.m., 3 p.m., 7 p.m., just like for the graduates, 9 a.m., 11 a.m., 3 p.m., 7 p.m. We're going to have an awesome free gift. It's going to be great. And then this Wednesday at 7 p.m., join us in the middle of your week for a great spiritual uplift at 7 p.m. Our communion message today, I believe, is one that's going to touch your heart. Now, maybe you're saying, oh, communion, I didn't know. Well, you've got time. Just go on out there to the kitchen or whatever and get that cracker, that piece of bread, that juice, or if all you have is some bottled water, put it in a little cup. Because once we consecrate it, it becomes the Lord's body, the Lord's blood, the Lord's supper. There's miracles that happen in communion. And that's why I chose this word from the Lord today. And I believe it's going to lift you up. The scriptures that we've chosen are going to remind you about the power of Holy Communion. I feel Jesus right now. Somebody better get ready. Get your elements ready. I believe this is a miracle time, a miracle day for you. Our message is entitled Strength from Our Spiritual Rock, Jesus Christ. Strength from our spiritual rock, Jesus Christ. And we read from 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 4. And did all drink the same spiritual drink? For they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock was Christ. Notice those words there. They drank, and that rock was Christ. Today, when we take that juice or whatever you may have, we're drinking of that rock called Jesus Christ. We take it in to our bodies. We affirm 1 John 4:4, greater is he who is in us than he that is within this world. I want to share with you today some things about communion. First of all, communion reminds us that Jesus is the rock of our salvation. I'm glad to report to you today that your salvation is not feeling-based. Because there's some days maybe we don't act as we should, we don't do as we should, and the devil would like to tell us, well, maybe you're not really saved, maybe you don't have a relationship with God. The Bible said that the just will live by faith, and when you take communion, it reminds you that your salvation is not in how you feel. Your salvation is in your relationship and the rock, Jesus Christ. I'd like to read Acts chapter 4, verse 12. Neither there is salvation in any other, for there is no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. How about John chapter 3, verse 16? Would you read that with me? I guarantee you most of you know that one. Come on, read it out loud with me right now. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him, that's Jesus, should not perish but have everlasting life. When I take communion, first of all, number one, it reminds me, it reminds us that Jesus is the rock of our salvation. Secondly, communion can help bring God's restoration power into our lives. I'll tell you, I have been in communion services where miracles happen right before our eyes. I have seen people literally have a transformation as they were discerning the power of communion. And I believe that that is going to happen for many of us today in the name of Jesus. Now remember, communion's coming up in just a few minutes. Get your cracker, your bread. Get that little juice, that water. It's getting ready for miracle time. Communion brings God's restoration power into our lives. We know this because of Psalm 23, verse 3. David writes these words: He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Somebody repeat after me, say, He restores. I believe on communion day that God can restore anything you ever lost. It might take a few days, it might take a few months, but listen, I am a living testimony that God can restore you. You can go through struggles, you can go through tough times, but God can always help you get back up again. He is a God of restoration. That's why you need to take this communion and let the Lord restore anything in your heart, in your mind, and in your spirit, because I believe that He will do it. From the top of this message, we said our Communion Sunday sermon is entitled Strength from Our Spiritual Rock, Jesus Christ. First of all, communion reminds us that Jesus is the rock of our salvation. Secondly, communion can help bring God's restoration power into our lives. I believe that restoration is coming, and I believe as you get in your prayer requests, I feel prompted by the Holy Ghost to tell you on Communion Sunday, get in your prayer requests right now. Faith City Family Church Facebook, the message section, or the YouTube, the chat section. I want to get them in my hand live here in real time because we believe in the miracle power of prayer. Here's something else about communion. At communion, Jesus is our source of guidance and direction. Somebody watching right now, you need direction. I think in that big stack of prayer requests, Valerie, if you're watching me, I think you had on your request, you need direction regarding a decision. I believe prayer and communion is going to empower you to make the decision that God wants you to make. These verses, listen to this about Jesus guiding our lives. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 1 through 6. My son, forget not my law, but let thine heart keep my commandments for length of days and long life, and peace shall they add unto thee. Let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them about thy neck. Write them upon the table of thine heart. Look at the outcome if we do this. So shalt thou find favor and good understanding in the sight of God and man. Please note these final words. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Somebody watching me right now, listen to this. You've got to make a decision soon. Listen to this. Lean not to your own understanding. In all of your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. Pastor, did it just say, if I acknowledge God, if I have a conversation with God, God will give me direction? That's what I said. When you have a conversation with God, which in essence is prayer, and you humble yourself and you say, God, I don't know everything. I don't have all the answers. I don't know how to navigate through these times. And you humble yourself. The Lord says in James chapter 1, if a man or woman lack wisdom, let them ask of God, who giveth to all men liberally. God will give you the wisdom that you need. Let's review. On Communion Sunday, make sure you have your wafer, your cracker, your bread, your juice, your water. A miracle's about to happen in your life. From the top of this message, strength from our spiritual rock, Jesus Christ. First of all, communion reminds us that Jesus is the rock of our salvation. Secondly, communion can help bring God's restoration power into our lives. Thirdly, at communion, Jesus is our source of guidance and direction. And finally, as our musicians come and find their way, Jesus is the foundation of our well-being. Yes, amen. Sister Cuff, as our musicians are finding their way, I feel the anointing and the power of Almighty God that's going to happen when we take this communion. Our final point at communion, Jesus is the foundation of our well-being and happiness. Listen to these verses. Psalm 37, verse 3 to 7. Trust in the Lord and do good. So shalt thou dwell in the land. And verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. And he shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light, and thy judgment as the noonday. Note these words. Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man that bringeth wicked devices to pass. And then Philippians chapter 4, verse 4. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice. When we take communion, Jesus is the foundation of our well-being and our happiness. Are you ready? I brought to church today from home a plastic little cereal bowl, and inside are my crackers. I found a little cup, smallest I could find, little coffee cup with my juice. That's my communion. And God's going to honor it. God's going to honor your communion. Maybe it's a little piece of bread, it's a wafer, it's a piece of a waffle, maybe it's a piece of cereal. When God touches it, the power comes into the situation. So are you ready? Together, come on, let's get our little wafer, our cracker, which is now the body of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The Bible says that it was on the night that Jesus was betrayed that Jesus gathered his disciples. And he took a piece of bread and he began to break that bread up, the Bible says, and he began to give it to his disciples and pass it out to his disciples. And you are a disciple of Christ. I am a disciple of Christ. And he says, it represents my body, which is about to be crucified. As oft as you do it in remembrance of me. I believe that when the body of Jesus goes into your mouth, down your throat, and into your body, I believe miracle power, delivering power, healing power, wisdom power, restoration power comes into your life. Are you ready? Let us take the body of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Let's take a moment and praise him right now. I believe many of you are feeling the power and presence of the Lord Jesus right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Lord, we give you praise. God is working on it right now. God is giving you healing, giving you wisdom, giving you what you need. In the name of Jesus, raise your hand and give God praise right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You will never be the same in the name of Jesus. And now we reach for the cup. As the Bible said that Jesus, on the night that he was betrayed, raised the cup, and he said to his disciples, this cup represents my blood, which is about to be shed for you. As often as you do it in remembrance of me. And he went on to say, for without the shedding of blood, there can be no forgiveness of sin. What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Are you ready? Let us take the blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Praise him right now. Somebody's getting a miracle. Somebody's getting a visit from the Holy Spirit. God is empowering you from the top of your head to the soles of your feet. Right now, in the name of Jesus, God is empowering you. Give him praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yes, thank you, my brother. And now for the prayer requests. For anyone that has contacted us, where he said we would pray at the close here, as Brother Harmon will bring the prayer box, the previous request. We will anoint with oil in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I feel the power of God right now. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Please pray for my son, Gray, to open his heart back up to his mother, Jackie. Please pray for deliverance for Joshua. Pray for deliverance and release of this stronghold in Jesus' name. Pray for Deneen, new CNO job in the States. Pray for a 24-hour miracle for Cheryl and Kenyette to be delivered from pain in the body. Prayers for Tiana to leave an abusive relationship. Prayer for my niece mourning the death of her mother, submitted by Dawn. Pray that the church will rise up and share the gospel like never before. Amen, Jeanette. Pray for the Dorsey family to be delivered from all generational curses. Pray that my brother develops better eating habits and healthy weight, says Dawn. Pray for my family and friends and myself, says Sky. Rocio praying God reunites broken families. George says pray for my sister and her sons. Pray for the Boston David and Smith families for the loss of their loved ones, for all families mourning, submitted by Mika. Pray for my dad, Charles, in the burn unit at Chester Hospital. He has recovered from COVID-19 while he was there. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Teniano, God bless you. Pray for Buck Conley to be healed from stage 4 cancer, and that he and his family share their testimony. Amen. Thank you, God, for healing, deliverance, breakthrough, and most of all, salvation for your people. Amen, patients. Pray for the Orlando Massey. He needs a 24-hour miracle from a congested heart problems. Pray for healing and deliverance and salvation of all humanity in Jesus' mighty name. In the closing moments, I believe we have a few more. We're going to lay hands on them for our benediction in just a moment. Household salvation. Amen, Virginia. We're believing. We're going to pray. Brother Harmon and I take the oil, and we begin to lay hands, and we anoint with oil every one of these requests. In the name of God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Ghost, God, we rebuke sickness and disease in the name of Jesus. We rebuke addiction and depression. God, we pray that families will be reunited, that children will be reunited with parents. God, we pray for a household salvation in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we pray for all salvation and breakthrough for your people today in the name of Jesus, and that people will rise up and share the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We declare all of this in the name of God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Yes, with just 4 minutes to go, I want to remind everyone that you can get your cross necklace. If you got saved today, I want to send you a cross necklace. If you are a veteran, just like Arlington Cemetery, all of the crosses that are there, we would love to send our veterans, or maybe you have a veteran in your family. Email me the address, faithcityoffice@gmail.com. Don't forget, graduates, we want to honor you. Make sure you email us a picture of yourself, your name, and the name of your school to faithcityoffice@gmail.com. And I'm going to ask Brother BK, in the last couple of moments we have, to scroll the different ways that you can give. For we are very much in need of your continued support, giving, and generosity. But now for the benediction, I stretch my hand out to you. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. We love you. God bless you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen and amen. Thank you for being with us, and God bless you.